team coming. Welcome to day 2 of rescue. Great day. First exercise is going to be sort of a confined space situation. Access for the teams to the main site is with this ladder. They need to go up with the ladder up there, and their casualty will be down there, and the rescuers will be coming from up there. So let's head up and see what they will be building. Little update so far. So I'm following Red River Rescue for this part of the exercise on the top, and then later on I film at the bottom. What I see people rig up is on the highest beam. You want more height because it gives you more room to move. So what they rig up is 2 anchor points, rigging plates, 2 clutches, and it's a basic C rig 3-2-1 with a change of direction at the top. So there's one guy up there able to control the clutches, and 2 guys down here on the other side doing the hauling. You can see it's a very, very tight fit, so I really hope to get the casualty through with the litter. It's going to be really, really tight. They're rigged and ready. They're ready to do the safety check, so float the load, do the safety check, and then start really hauling. Right now I'm looking at Dublin from the other side, doing the similar thing as to what Red River is doing. So have a look at the other ones. So these teams started a little bit later than the other ones. They have a lower anchor point. So Red River is using the top one, and they're actually 2 parts lower. I don't know if that will give them trouble. Probably not, actually. Probably they have the right height, and they're closer with climbing, close to each other with climbing up and down. They're still descending, they're throwing ropes down, and they're hauling ass already. All right, let's have a look. Float the load right now, doing a safety check, and then they're off to the haul. They're hauling right now. They have a 3-2-1 in clutches, like I said, and there's a little rope to pull the rope clamps back down for the reset. Looks like a pretty efficient system. Challenge number 3, not of today, but numbers by the organization. Quite a challenge. So we get these little towers up here. The casualty will be up there. That's a judge, but the casualty will be close to the judge. That one, it will be the casualty for one team, and they will be, it will be suspended in 2 separate anchor points away from the ropes. Then the rescuer is going to go up. They have to get up there, a rescuer. And at the moment, the rescuer makes contact and does the medical evaluation of the casualty. The rescuer gets unconscious. And one of them has low blood pressure. I'm not sure which one. So at that moment, that's a surprise for the teams, but they do know it beforehand. At that moment, they have a 2-person rescue, and they have to decide which one to get down first. So I think the time starts when they start shooting ropes up, or throwing ropes up, or going up, whatever way they decide to do. And the time stops when all the gear is away off the ground. So let's get into this. little recap of the challenge number three. We saw a lot of variations. We saw base anchors were mostly flexura slings wrapped around and choked. We saw sort of a wrap-free pool too, just ropes tied around and put into the rigging plate. Right now the team is rigging up with the grillons. I don't know how that is going to work out. We will see, or I won't see, because I'm leaving to the next one. So every team shoot the lines up. One was throwing, a really good throw, really high, accurate as well. Get the ropes up, rig the rescue. Rescue went up. At one point they became unconscious, and some teams had to throw a new line up for the second rescuer. Other teams just use the same lines. And there's various options. Some teams lower the capacity down, the most important one of the two. Other teams descended two persons down and left one capacity up, so the rescue had to go ascend back up again. I have no idea what the right way is, but yeah, solid effort. Off to the next one. Challenge number three for me for the day, but I forget which number the organization it is. Really, for me, a scary exercise. I've never done this stuff, so seeing them perform it was kind of exciting, especially when at the bottom over here looking back up. But the challenge is, on the roof of this building there's an incapacitated person, probably with a heat stroke over here, and they have to package the patient and bring them down. There is no elevator and nothing. They can use the elevator to bring the gear up just for the competition, but the way down, it's all from the roof down, and there's no anchor points at the bottom, except they have to use their vehicles for that. Meaning all kinds of different ways of rigging of the wheels, the hubs, the tow hooks, the, like when the vehicle breaks down, the little hooks, not the hitches. Also hitches. I've seen every team basically do the same thing. Twin tensioned track line going down and operated from the top on a twin tensioned rope, two clutches as well. The real challenge here is getting that stretcher over the edge and down, because if you look up and you can see it in the footage, when you get over the edge, there is no wall to stand against. That means you have to be really, really careful. And it looks pretty sharp as well, which probably it's not as bad as it looks from here. Then when you come down, there is, let me see if I can show you, there is like all the glass is coming into play, so that you need to stay away from the glass. But if you tension it properly, then the teams can stay pretty far away and actually land over here. There's like 15 meters of distance, something like that. I saw one pike and pivot, and the others were I saw two pike and pivot, and the other ones were just straight lift over the edge. So yeah, different methods, almost the same execution with slightly different variations. That's what it is, slightly different variations. So I'm gonna film one more team rigging from the bottom and see what they rig up. And look, yeah, let's go. Whoa. final challenge of the day is that teams arrive here. There's a set of ropes leading up, and up there on the roof there is a casualty. The roof is a weakened structure, so you cannot put any pressure on it or any gear. That's one. There is a slight platform where you can access the casualty, but that's it. That's one. So somebody needs to climb up here, but they have to be gentle with the wall and with the roofs and everything. With the wall and the windows and everything. And then they climb up, need to set an anchor point and a control site, everything. But usually we would like anchor points here, and we don't have those. So a lot of teams so far have been doing someone at the top beam doing all the control work, somebody below helping the casualty and lowering the casualty, and the rescuer down by using, well, there's nobody doing it right now, but by using two or three person as a counterweight to get them back against the wall, and various systems. But yeah, it's three bodies pulling the stretcher out of the wall to the backside. That's it. And then afterwards, the final one needs to descend down. So let's see if I can access the roof and have a closer look. Yeah, here we go. Day two is done.
This was a hot one.
My mind was boiled after this. You can see me, I was even wearing a hat, put on my long sleeve, wear a little buff, because like everything was burnt and cooked. Imagine what the people participating, how they felt. So it was a really cool day for this exercise. It was go up as quick as possible, get to the casualty, send a second guy up to create an anchor point, then get the casualty in the stretcher, lower them off, and take them away from the wall. So what I saw most people do was lower and pull in from three or four people at the bottom, lower and pull in. But I think it's possible to get like two or three people and just build like a sort of a tension line or a diagonal tramway. It doesn't even have to be that much tension. You just need to pull them away a little bit. That will save a lot of the bouncing back and forth. When they lower and lower down and pull in at the bottom, then you get this swinging motion going. And when it's like a static line, then it's just a smooth descent. You only need to be this far from the wall. You don't need to be way back. But that's me standing from the side without being in the competition. So very cool day. Off to day three. Let's go.